Hi everyone, this tutorial is going to help you build off of what we learned with the three-dimensional bar chart to make a pie chart. So I'm starting in the same place here. I've got my light and I've got my pre-comp. It's 3D and I have collapsed the transformations here so that I can get all the shadows and everything like that. So what I'm going to do is instead of using bars, I'm going to use ellipses. So instead of clicking on the rectangle, you can just click and hold and then go to the ellipse. What I want you to do is just click and drag. Oh, there we go. That's a problem. I've created a mask there. And the reason is that I was clicked on, I had selected this. I'm going to deselect it. So just click anywhere out here. And then I can redo it and get a shape. I'm going to hold down shift to make a perfect circle. And it looks pretty good. It might be a little smaller than I might want, but you can always change it later. So I'm going to go into my contents, go to the ellipse. Look at the transform, and I'm going to change this position to be 0 and then 0. So I want it to be completely centered within the shape itself. So the anchor point is completely centered. And then for in the regular transform, we've got 960 by 540, which is half of the screen resolution, which is 1920 this way by 1080 this way. So high definition. And so that looks about right. I want to make this 3D so that I can get some material layers and I can do everything like that. And I'm going to have this able to cast shadows. Okay. So I'm not going to worry too much about doing any rotation or anything like that. This is about as much as I want until I go into effects. So I want to make this look a little better first. And the first thing I'm going to do is go to Effects and go to Perspective and then Bevel Alpha. And what that's going to do is it's actually going to make the illusion of an edge all the way around this. And I'm going to make this pretty big, like let's say 25. And you can see what this does is it makes it look like it's three-dimensional. You can make it even rounder if you choose to. You could go all the way up to, I don't know, 50. You can have a really nice round piece there. And that looks pretty good. So I'm going to leave it at this way. You can see that it works with the lights, and it really does look three-dimensional here. Notice that I've also not changed my my distance away. I'm going to worry about all of that later on. The first thing I'm going to do, though, is start adding some more of these and changing their colors. So I'm going to go ahead and click on my shape layer, and I'm going to duplicate this. So Control-D or Command-D. Or you can always go to Edit, Duplicate, and I'm going to change the colors for each one. So for 5, I'm going to change it to blue. For 4, I'm going to change it to maybe this sky blue color. For 3, I'm going to change it to green. For 2, I'm going to change it to yellow. And then for 1, I'm going to change it to, or I'm going to, let's say I'll just leave it at red here. So I've got all sorts of different colors here. And of course, one is on top of the other, so you can't see them. You can only see the first one. So what we're going to do is look at how we can make this look like it's animating on. So the first thing I'm going to do is actually leave the entire shape 5 here, right? And I'm just going to, or actually I'm going to leave the entire shape 1 there, I'm sorry. And I'm going to animate the others on top of it. There's a lot of ways to do this. You can simply change shape 5 if you choose to. So let's say I just want to make this smaller. So I'm just going to reveal one piece of it. So you can go through and add some effects, which is what we're going to do now. So I'm going to add a radio wipe. So go to transition and then radio wipe. And I'm going to have the center again at 960 by 540, which is the center of the composition. And I'm going to have this animated on. So I'm going to go into my effects, or I can just do it here. I'm going to click on my transition completion at 0%, And then I'm going to move forward 1 second. And I'm going to have this change. So I want that piece to only be this one piece of the pie. Okay, so at this point, that's pretty much good to go. So in shape 4, I can do the same thing here, right? I can add a radial effect. And of course, you can do this each time, right? Or you can do it before you even copy it. But in this case, I'm going to go to Effect, and then Radial Wipe, because it saved it here. I'm going to... Oops, I just added a second one onto Shapewear 4. Effect, Radial Wipe for Shapewear 4. And I'm going to animate my transition completion again at this point. And notice how I'm playing it each time, so then I'm animating that. I'm going to go 1 second over, and I'm going to increase my transition completion. So basically what I'm doing is actually I'm revealing the pieces of the pie underneath it. So that's done for Shapewear 4. Shapewear 3, I can do the same thing. Just click on it, go to Effect, Radial Wipe, animate my transition, go forward in a second or so, and then change how much of it I want available. So let's say it's like that. Shapewear 2, Effect, Radial Wipe, animate, drag this in, and then Shapewear 1 is the last piece, which I actually don't need to animate at all. So all I'm doing, because it's completely revealed here. And then all we need to do is add our copy around it, so we can take our text layer and make one here. So this would be the same as the last piece. So let's say this is Rollins, et cetera, Rollins, Elon, Dartmouth, whatever you want to do. So what I want to do at this point is actually alter this a teeny bit. And to do that, I'm going to click, highlight all of these, so click and then shift click to highlight them all. And then I'm going to go to rotation. And I want to rotate them all just a little bit. So I'm going to rotate them on the x-axis. I'm going to rotate them down like that. And you can see that that's actually pushing behind the grid and everything. So I'm done with rotation there. So I just press R again to collapse it. And then I'm going to press P for position. And I'm going to drag the Z axis out so that we're over everything. And there you go. We have a nice pie chart here that actually all animates on together. So we start blank. And you can also do a radial wipe for that one as well. So you can have it start with nothing. But I prefer to not do that. Then you have those pieces of the pie animate on. And you're good to go. Once you add your copy in, this makes a really attractive chart. When you go to your custom view and press C for the camera, you can actually see how nice this is. One of the problematic parts about doing it this way is that the wipe changes angle along with your project. So you can see that it doesn't actually work completely when you rotate around. So you have to keep it at this one angle. The way to get around that is to actually make a pre-comp. So I can remove my position. I can take all of these pieces and make them into another composition. So I can right-click, make it into a pre-composition. I'm going to leave it at pre-comp 1. Just to show you how it's done. And you can see again it loses the light here, but I want to make this into 3D. And once it's 3D, if we go to our custom view, you can see that it doesn't change as you move here. But you have lost something, right? So if you go back to the active camera, you are going to have to then redo those certain of those areas. So you're going to have to change its... change your angle and all of that kind of stuff, right? So you might want to change your X orientation, change your X rotation again, and change your Z position, change your material options to cast shadows. And you can see you have pretty much the same process there. But in this case, you actually don't lose the radial wipe. So it adds a couple of steps, but you can see why, in this case, a pre-composition is so incredibly important. And of course, you can open this pre-comp and add another light to it if you want to really get some shadows or whatever you need. But I think at this point, this looks really quite nice. Good luck.